Hello, everyone. Starting a little bit early. Getting ready to make some nature paint brushes with materials that you can find around your house and in your yard. I am going live for the first time here from my home, but for Bookworm Gardens. And I invite you to comment and share. Tell me that you're here. Say hello. Pulling up comments right now so that I can answer any questions that you might have. And we'll get started in just a few minutes. Hello, everyone who's just joined. I see some people are watching from home. Glad that you're here. We're going to get started in just a few minutes. I encourage you to say hello. Let us know that you are here watching. I'm pulling up your comments right now so that if you have any questions, you can let us know. All right, we've got lots of folks that are joining us right now. Hello, Brenda. Hello, Tamara. Wonderful to see you all here. We are excited for the season as well. Thank you for that. So it is 11 o'clock and we are gonna get started. My name is Kate Tinker and I am the Director of Education at Bookworm Gardens. We are very excited to have you at the gardens later on this year. But until then, we have created a new resource called Busy with Bookworm, in which we have lots of different resources available to you, some through horticulture, some through literature, art making, sneak peeks into our garden season, some new gardens that are joining us at Bookworm in the 2020 season. 2020 is also our 10th anniversary season, so we're really excited for our big birthday this year. But in the meantime, we have lots of different resources available to you via social media and our website so that you can enjoy some behind the scenes, but also do some things yourself at your home. Hi, Trisha. Thanks for watching. Keep commenting, guys. Let me know that you are here, and please let me know if you have any questions. So today we are going to be making nature paint brushes, and I'm going to start by going over some materials. Now, I'm going to also let you know that all of these materials can be changed. So if you don't have paint at home, I'm going to be posting online on our social media some ways that you can make your own paint. If you don't have some of the particular plants that I'm using, you can choose to clip some other plants from your garden or maybe take some things from dried reeds or other things that you have around the house that you're no longer using. So some of the things that we are going to be using today are some sticks. These are willow sticks. They're super skinny and super long, but you can use any sticks that you have in your garden or outside, maybe when you're going for a walk. We are also going to use rubber bands. So I've got some plain rubber bands here that we are going to use to attach our natural materials to our DIY nature paint sticks. So you can use rubber bands, but you can also use tape or any materials that you might have around the house that you can use for your paint brushes. Speaking of paint, I have two different types of paint here today. We have tempera paint and we also have acrylic paint. For those of you that know paint, you know that tempera is easier to wash out of clothing and other items. The acrylic paint is a little bit more challenging, but put on an old shirt, get messy, or you can paint outside on a little bit of a warmer day. So it's really up to you what type of paint that you would like to use. You can also explore painting with watercolor, painting with whatever you might have around. And again, I'm going to be posting some recipes about ways that you can make your own paint at home as well if you don't have any on hand. So the other thing that we are definitely going to need for our nature paint brushes is Natural Elements. So this is really a fun thing because I think it can become a little bit of a scavenger hunt. You can go out into your environment, whether that's your garden or on a walk, and collect different materials that you can use to create your paintbrush. So I have collected a variety of materials from around my home and from around my garden space here in Sheboygan that I have at my house to showcase. So we've got some boxwood that we're going to be using today. I also clipped some dried sedum here. So this is from last year's sedum. So that's the top, the flowers of that. These, I believe, were dried from some phlox out in the gardens. They have a really cool texture that you can see. I had a wreath that I wasn't using anymore that had some lemon leaves, dried lemon leaves on them. So I clipped those off. It also had these really cool seed pods. I was looking up how to pronounce it. I think it's phalaris, but I might need to ask our director of horticulture and be sure. But these were on a dried wreath and I wasn't using them anymore. And I thought they could create a cool texture. I've got some pussy willow that was dried from last year. So those have these cool fuzzies on them too. And I found a really cool seed pod in our yard that had fallen off of a tree that I thought could make a really cool texture for our paintbrushes. Of course, you can choose to clip some conifers, some evergreens, different textures. We've also used these in the holiday season to make DIY wrapping paper and some printing projects as well. And then finally, I had some dried lavender that I picked up at the Sheboygan Farmers Market last year that I thought would make a really cool texture as well. So this is gonna be kind of like a cooking show. I'm gonna show you how to put together your paintbrushes using all of these materials. And then I also have a finished product that I'm gonna take out of my oven. So it's also important to note that if you're gonna be painting, you might want to have some sort of a smock material. For us today, we decided to use a palette that we had around the house. So this is actually a styrofoam meat tray that we use at the gardens a lot for different paint. So what I did is I poured a small amount of paint into our meat tray for our palette. You can also use extra cardboard or an egg container, plastic egg container if you want. Just use your recycled materials around the house to create your own palette. Hi, Ezra, nice to see you too. Make sure to comment and ask questions if you have any on the materials that I'm using. Some other materials that I have is, I have Felco pruners that I used, especially with my sticks, but the other thing that can work is plain old scissors. So I have these bare bone scissors that I like for herbs and things in the gardens, but you can use any scissors that you have to help you cut your materials as well. So I'm gonna start with my skinny stick here. I also have a rubber band. And then I'm gonna decide which material I would like to affix to the end of my paintbrush. I think I'm going to start with some of the evergreen that I picked from my garden. I'm just gonna pull these different pieces off. It's also kind of fun to, you can touch this and see it's not very prickly because it was fresh. You can smell it, full sensory experience. Ooh, it smells really good. It kind of smells Christmassy. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all these materials into a little bunch. I might want to use my scissors here to cut them to be the same length, but I don't need to. I can just kind of pull them apart if I don't want to use the scissors or I don't have scissors handy. I'm creating this little bunch and I'm going to have my stick here and I'm going to put it right here on the end. So you can see this is my paintbrush taking form. And then, great fine motor skills for kiddos out there, you can choose to use rubber bands or tape to start wrapping the end of your natural material to your stick. Again, I encourage you to look and get creative. What materials do you have at home? The idea is that we're using this art making project so that we don't need to leave our natural spaces that we have available to us. So whether that's your backyard or a walk in your neighborhood while you're taking your dog out. So you have all these materials. You just need to look creatively for them. All right, so these seem like they're pretty well affixed. So here I have a finished product, one of my paint brushes here. I've got the evergreen kind of on the end here. I've got the rubber band in my stick. It almost looks a little bit like a Harry Potter magic wand. I'm enjoying that right now. I also made one earlier that has some boxwood on it here as well. So I'm gonna need something to paint on. So we hadn't really talked about what different materials we could paint on. So I have plain white paper. This is a little bit thick. You can also use plain old printing paper. You can, mom and dad, someone's working at home, you can turn over and recycle paper on the other side and use whatever you kind of have around. I also really like to use recycled cardboard or other things for a different type of background, which is a lot of fun. So I've got my paper down here, and I have my palette that I filled with paint right here. I think I'm gonna add a little bit more of this rich navy blue color. I decided to do all blues and greens. If you know me, those are my favorite colors, but they also remind me of nature. And I just think that having a little bit of a special palette of your favorites is kind of a fun thing to do. So I see, Trisha's saying she likes to use leftover boxes to paint. You can even maybe create a fort and put it outside with leftover boxes and then have the kids go to town decorating it any way they want. One of the things that's really special about using a variety of different materials is that we're going to get different textures. So I'm going to start with black here, and I'm just going to gently dip this in the paint, and then I'm just going to start experimenting with what this is going to look like. This is giving me nice long strokes here. Just really kind of fun way to experiment with different textures. So you can see the texture that this is giving me is just like it looks, I don't know. I might just start, what does that look like to you all? Anyone want to comment? I think it's kind of fun to just experiment and see what might come out of it. I think I'm gonna go with blue next. We've got two different color blues because my palette is a little mixed. And I think I'm just gonna try and, go like this a little bit more and see what kind of texture that comes up with. Kind of like a polka dotted situation happening right there. I wonder if, I don't even need a stick for this pussy willow. This is a long enough piece that I could just dip this in a little bit of the paint and see, this does longer brush strokes here, and I can experiment with some swirls. Very nice. I like this. And we're starting to blend in with the other color here. So just making different shapes and experimenting. If you have younger children, this might be a really great time to talk about mixing paint colors and what that looks like. Reminds me of A Little Cloud by Eric Carle. I love that. Finn says that these look like stripes on a tiger. So maybe you want to use your nature paint brushes for some inspiration, and then you can go back in, let it dry a little bit, and go back in with your favorite materials like crayons or colored pencils or markers and fill in the rest. Lily says it looks like a zebra. Deb thinks maybe this could be like a pond situation going on down here. I love all the different ideas that are coming up. So if you have any questions about any of the materials that we were using today, feel free to add those in the comments and I can answer those questions for you. In the meantime, I wanted to talk a little bit about some of the books that I love that are art-centered and art-focused. One of the reasons that we decided to choose nature paint brush making today is because we are going to have a new garden called Action Jackson that is a book that's all inspired by Jackson Pollock. So if you were on social media yesterday, you would have seen our executive director, Elizabeth Wieland, and you can still watch that video, Facebook and Instagram and on our website, read aloud to her children, Action Jackson. That's going to be in our creative garden coming up in this 2020 season. I also really love the book Mix It Up. It's all about color mixing by Henry Toulet. We have over here, Mouse Paint is another book that I really love that you can take out of your stash or look up online by Ellen Stoll Walsh. And a fan favorite for camp is My Many Colored Days by Dr. Seuss as well. So you can think about ways that you can integrate the literature into your nature component for this art making experience. So it can be like a full rounded. Now you can do this all in a day if you're feeling like it, or maybe one day you go collect your materials for a scavenger hunt, and the next day you want to read a book that's inspired by art, and then on your third day you can do some creating or some making inspired by this. For the rest of today, we're going to be posting on our social media different book opportunities, different material lists, some photos, and we'd love to hear from you about ways in which you think we could extend this activity. So maybe we can use this as a counting activity. We can count how many different nature materials we're finding out inside in the gardens or on our walk. You might be able to use this as color matching or color identification, some vocabulary integration. There are a lot of different ways that you can extend this learning. I also love that this project is great for all ages. I'm having fun with it, and your littles will have fun with it, but I think it's really something that you can use for any age. Also remember that you can tag us in your picture using the hashtag BusyWithBookworm. BusyWithBookworm is our series of all different types of making experiences that we're doing, and literature and horticulture experiences that you can do from your home. So without further ado, I'm gonna say goodbye for today. It was so exciting to do our first live video here with Busy with Bookworm. And I thank you so much for joining us here. Someone was saying, saving our used nature paintbrushes to hang from a mobile in our fort outside. Okay, Rachel, that sounds really, really awesome. Feel free to comment on any other ideas that you might have with to do with your nature paintbrushes. If you have any additional questions, feel free to comment on this video, and we will be responding. But until then, I hope that you stay safe, that you're reading lots of books, and that you're getting as much outdoor time as you can. And we look forward to seeing you at the gardens sometime in the future. Thank you so much for joining us, and have a beautiful rest of the day. Bye.